fight any more time.
Well, an early finish to our first
fight. We've got our first in the all international flavor fight next.
A couple of big guys, 94 kilos.
Corner, out of Russia, he has fought 5 fights and won 3 of those fights. His name is Evgen Golovin.
Evgen Golovin from Russia now.
Always fun to see the big boys, these two weighing in at a hefty at 94 kilos each. That means that they probably hit hard, and it wouldn't surprise me to see another stoppage in our second fight.
And the big guys let the shots go. Definitely not good blitz at all.
What the small fighters tend to bring to the table is a lot of speed, but what you get with these big fighters is a lot of power.
And in the red corner, fighting out of USA, he has fought 15 fights and won 8 of those fights. His name is Alex Popilatum.
So Alex Popilatum from America now, America versus Russia in our second event.
Shades of Rocky Five here.
So Alex training out Popilatum gym in Bangkok. Gym owned by the legendary Samar Payakarun. One of the most famous, widely regarded pound for pound, the best Muay Thai fighter ever. He's old coach here tonight as well. Kru Yodtong Sinan from Sit Yodtong Jin, based here in Pattaya. One of the Yonkou training centers.
And we've also got a bit of boxing royalty in attendance in Yodtong and Sit Yodtong, former world champion. Square Garden, one of the most famous all-time Thai boxers, who's also at Sid Yodtong, now based down at Evolve MMA in Singapore. Yodtong was also a very good Muay Thai fighter, much like Somlak Kamsing, was able to transition fairly seamlessly between the two disciplines. Waikru gets underway. Foreign fighters don't always perform the Waikru, it is optional. Interesting to see whether these two do. The advantage goes to the American in terms of experience, Alex Popilatum. He's had 15 fights, he's won 8 of them, he's lost 7. And a record like that sometimes indicates that a fighter's faced a very high caliber of opposition.
It also means that he's not very good.
Evgen Golovin, he's had 5 fights, slightly less experience. He's won 3 and he's lost 2. I guess we're going to find out just how good he is in any minute now. Both men looking very confident. Evgen really taking his time here, looks very composed. See if he can maintain that composure once the bell sounds.
So Alex with a longer wide crew of the two.
Fighters will always circle the ring just to seal off the corners, but whether you actually perform the dance is up to the individual fighter. I think all Thai fighters do, but some foreigners opt not to.
Unless, of course, you're fighting in the main stadiums, Lumpini or Rajma, it's kind of a requirement.
It's compulsory, is it, in the main stadiums? Are there any sort of regulations as to the length of the white
crew? No.
But it's not enough to merely circle the ring.
It needs to be a little bit more than that. Starting to fill up a little bit nicely now. Obviously, early days yet. The second fight on the show.
I'm sure the place is going to be absolutely packed by the time we get around to our main event. Huge amount of anticipation, not just down here in Pattaya, but all over Thailand for this fight.
And also a lot of people, I believe, are tuning in around the world to the stream. Muay Thai Combat TV. Yok Kow have done an incredible amount to really push Muay Thai in the last couple of years. They've invested a lot in bringing some camps through, sponsoring fighters and putting on big shows around the world, which is only good for a sport. Recently, they put on the show in America, in Madison Square Garden, Muay Thai at the Mecca. Which can only be good for the sport, to really get it out there, get people knowing what it's about.
Yeah, Madison Square Garden, a venue which is more traditionally associated with boxing. You've seen legends down the year. Muhammad Ali has fought there many times. More recently, Miguel Cotto. And it's fantastic to see the sport of Muay Thai being represented at such a prestigious venue. And all credit to Yok Kow for bringing that sport to the Americans and to the Italians and all over the world. There was a little bit of controversy on the last Yok Kow show in Italy when Sanchai lost to Fabio Pinca.
Still a long white crew here from Alex. The crowd getting a little bit impatient. Want to see some action.
Sanchai, of course, will be back in action in January, taking on Diesel Leck.
That's another credit to Yok Kow as well. Putting on a fight like that, that would headline Lumpini Stadium. Two Thai fighters, there's a fight a lot of Thai crowd would want to see. Managing to get that on in Italian soil. And also get it out there to the world via the pay-per-view stream that will be coming up for that event. Not to be missed. Also, I believe on that card, Kem Sitsongpinong versus Jordan Watson from England. Jordan always comes to fight, shared the ring with some very big names in the past, Boakao Porpamon, Yodsenkai has given them all let them all know that they've been in a fight. Just recently lost on points to Ekpatam in the Yotin.
Yeah, I'm told that was a very, very competitive, a very entertaining fight. Jordan always puts on a good fight. We've also got Frankie Georgie fighting Ekpatam Minyotin, who was Jordan's opponent at that recent show. Frankie Georgie, who reached the final of Thai Fight recently.
Yeah, he lost to Boakao in last year's Thai Fight final, a year ago.
Beat Vusi in the semi-final, I believe. Vusi Colossa, the South African fighter.
Ready to get the action underway, any in second now. Said before, but these big guys, they pack a lot of power into the shots. Don't blink, because any one shot could take either guy out.
I think Yevgen is a local fighter, getting a bit of a cheer from the crowd there.
Bumpa, the referee in the ring there, one of the Lumpini Stadium's highly regarded referees. A couple of years ago, won the referee of the year for Lumpini Stadium.
And we're underway. Yevgen Golovin from Russia in the blue shorts. Alex Poptilatam from America in the red shorts. Both fighters weighing in at 94 kilos for this contest.
Solid low kick there at the start from Yevgeny.
Yeah, already you can see the difference in styles there between Alex, who's very light on his feet, bouncing around a little bit, and Yevgen, who likes to set himself a little bit more, not quite so much movement.
Sunk in a couple of solid low kicks already.
Bit of a wild right hand there from Alex, doesn't quite connect, but had bad intentions written all over it.
Sharp jab from Evgeny, good block from Alex, and the counter low kick from Alex.
Yeah, right hand over the top coming in there from Yevgen. Already we're seeing quite a lot more action than we did in that previous fight.
Yeah, I don't think there's a good chance this might not go to five rounds. Solid low kick again there from Alex, he's really putting a lot of venom into them.
Yeah, Yevgen won't want to take too many of those.
Alex with a very bouncy style.
Another nice low kick there from Yevgen.
So the main fight moving into the clinch now. Evgeny getting the better of Alex in the clinch.
Alex still very light on his feet, smile on his face. guard looks wide open, though. Yevgen's already had some success with that jab. Be interested to see whether he utilises that more as the fight progresses.
Not very much a boxer's stance there when he's holding the left glove low. Wants to be careful with that. He's got a hard low kick going in.
He's taken a few of those low kicks. He won't want to keep taking those for the full 15 minutes. Solid but a right, solid right hand. Yevgen gets straight to his feet.
You see Evgeny's face there. He felt that shot. Giving Alex a bit of hope there. Wild shot there.
Yeah, Alex looks like he's looking to land a big punch here.
So watch him not burn himself out though. He's going in very fast at the moment, that bouncing about. It'll take up a lot of energy.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see whether he can sustain this particular style for five rounds.
He's definitely looking more comfortable, the more composed at the moment, more relaxed, and a hard long kick from him.
And just as you say that, you're getting a little bit wild, throwing a couple of hooks himself, and I think Alex landed with a left hand there. Straight right to the body, but didn't have too much on it from Alex. And there's a first knee of the fight to the midsection again from Alex.
A hard low kick from Eugene, big left hook from him. Solid shot to the body. Just losing his balance here. I think he just went down to get away from that shot from Alex. So yeah. End of round number one.
I think that straight right hand at the end there, I think it looked more dramatic than it did just because he had a hold of his leg and he was off balance. I don't think any real damage was done with that shot, but very entertaining first round, plenty of action there. These are two big guys throwing big hard punches, and as we said earlier, this is one fight which might not go the distance.
Telling him to use the body kick. Low kick possibly. Follow up his punches with a shot, with a kick.
Yotsen is 38 now, I think he's in excellent condition. He did move into MMA briefly, had a couple of fights, enjoyed some success with that, and he was threatening to make a comeback recently as a boxer, so we'll see if anything comes of that, but he's still in fantastic condition for a 38-year-old man.
Entertaining to see the big guys swinging for the hills.
Yeah, and I'm expecting more of the same in this round.
Left hook there from Evgeny.
I think Alex took that on the gloves.
Both fighters dangerously close to the commentary position. I don't want one of them landing on my head.
Yeah, Alex is sometimes off balance, which makes the shots that he's receiving look a little bit more effective than perhaps they are, but there was a solid-looking knee in there from Yevgeny. Now, Alex holding his hands very low.
He's moving back out, swaying back out of the way quite quick, though.
Shades of soft luck
Kamsi. Not really found a way to exploit that yet.
That was an attempt at a Superman punch there from Alex. Not a traditional Muay Thai technique, but no rule against employing it.
The referee really got his work cut out on this fight. He's going to earn his money tonight. Solid low kick from Alex this time. Seems to have slowed down a bit more now. Not so much bouncing out. Oh, beautiful right hand now.
Alex just smiles it off, but generally when a fighter smiles, that means they're hurt.
Good low kick from Evgen. Kicking him off a bit there, very wild at the moment, Alex.
Yeah, Alex has some very unconventional movement.
He's putting so much into his shots, he's coming off balance and then getting caught with a counter shot every time.
Yeah, he's leaving himself exposed a little bit. He was very fortunate there, had his head close
nice
to the ground.
Nice sneeze there from Evgen. He's looking the stronger of the two now. Alex looking a little bit tired, maybe.
Evgen reaching a little bit with that jab.
A good low kick from him. Still dangerous though with those punches, Alex, when he comes in.
pace starting to slow a little bit now.
Ricard is feeling the pace, yeah. Big guys like this, it doesn't take much to burn them out. Big shot there from Alex again, from Evgen again, sorry. Alex in the corner.
That's a nice bit of technique there.
Referee there just telling him off, using the ropes, taking advantage of your opponent. A big no-no, especially in the main stadium now. It can almost go against you, almost as much as getting a count. Get caught holding the ropes and the referee tells you off.
When you've got 95 kilos to carry around, it's definitely hard work and difficult for the bigger fighters to keep up with the same kind of pace that we see from some of the smaller fighters.
Already in this fight, two rounds gone. Both fighters really gone for it from the off. Which is what the fans have come to see.
And I wonder now, as we start to enter the important scoring rounds, whether the judges will favour the Muay Thai technique of the Russian over the slightly more wild boxing-based approach of the American. Still a long way to go yet, three more rounds. And the stadium really started to fill up now. In the second event of the night, we've got eight fights on the card. As round three gets underway.
Round number three coming up. Alex from America, Alex Popteroton from America in the red shorts, and Evgen Golovin from Russia in the blue shorts.
The Evgen is looking to land that jab now, but Alex has stepped back.
There he is, making himself open again. Good solid hook there though, but just leaving himself open a lot with his shots, Alex.
Oh, Alex tagged him with a right hand there. Didn't seem to have too much effect on the Russian, who counters with a low right kick of his own. Not the first time he's landed that strike, and Alex takes it and throws a low kick of his own.
Looking for the knee to the head in the clinch there. Strong round for Alex so far. He's come out fast.
Yeah, he looks strong in the clinch. Just tried to throw Evgen off balance.
Solid low kick again from Evgen.
Yeah, Alex just starting to look a little bit like he's those low kicks are starting.
Another hard low kick again there. That one hurt.
Let's keep an eye on that left leg of his.
About keeping an eye on it, he needs to use it to block. Another solid couple of punches there from Evgen. Solid low kick again, just losing his balance there. Looks like he's limping a little bit now. Yeah, those low kicks are doing the damage there.
He already seems like he's moving a little bit unnaturally, trying not to put weight on that leg. You can already see some red welts underneath those red shorts.
Nice work in the clinch again from the Russian fighter. Alex slowed down again now. Another hard low kick there.
Very solid low kick.
Good knees. Evgen in control here. Corner screaming at him to get forward. Make that leg pay. They can see that he's hurt. They want him to finish the fight.
If I was in his corner, I would be telling him to keep going to that right leg kick. It's been his most effective weapon so far. As I mentioned earlier, kicks to the midsection do tend to score a little bit better with the judges, but the kicks to that right thigh can really immobilise an opponent. Very effective.
Good punch
weapons
there, though. But that so far has really been Alex's only chance. That wild overhand right, the wild punches. Evgeny controlling the ring otherwise.
I think Alex is deliberately...
Just hurt him there, I think, with something.
Some good exchanges there as Alex throws him to the floor.
The crowd enjoying this. So we're into round number three.
I think Alex might have been pacing himself a little bit more in that round, seemed to fight in bursts.
It's not been a fight for those fans of the technical mastery of the art of Muay Thai, but it's entertaining nonetheless.
Yeah, of course, we've got a lot of variety on the card tonight. The main event, two of the top Thais, Kem Sitsong Pinong and Yodson Fly Fairtex. But we've got a real mixture, a variety of weights, variety of nationalities. It's going to be a really entertaining night for the fans. And there is typically a contrast in approaches between the Thai fighters and the foreign fighters. As we've mentioned earlier, the Thais tend to start more slowly. Also, typically, we'll use the knees and kicks a lot. Foreign fighters typically tend to use their boxing, use their hands. Of course, there are exceptions to the rule.
The corner there for Evgen, just telling him to keep it tight, composed, not too wild, pick your shots. Basically what he's been doing all night, just avoid those wild bombs from Alex and just keep firing away, popping away at that leg.
I imagine they probably took advantage of the break between rounds to get some ice on that left leg for Alex. See if that's helped.
Round four. Might go that far, but it has.
No, we both said we didn't think this one would go the distance, and these fighters appear to be in the process of proving us wrong. Still almost 6 more minutes to go. Some big shots coming in there from Alex, really letting his hands go. He's
leaving his hands wide open though. Beautiful left hook from Evgen there. Alex plants his feet, lets the shot go, but his chin's right up in the air. Another good low kick from Evgen and a sharp left hook on the as he's on the retreat as well.
There's some great action at the start of this fourth round. Alex finally checking the kick there. I think that's going to be important for him.
It's also a sign that it's really hurting.
Solid right hand to the midsection for Alex. Follows it up by sweeping away the standing leg of Yevgeny.
Another hard low kick there. He's pulling the head down. Alex can't let him pull the head down like that in the clinch. Those knees have been coming in high. Wardrobe adjustment there from Evgen. And a low kick.
Yeah, that one landed in an unfortunate area. The referee will just give him a few seconds to recover. I think he's okay though. The Russian wants to carry on fighting.
Just checking that the groin piece was still in place.
And again, I think Alex is pacing himself.
Yeah. I think he's tired. He's fought very wild and very tense as well. He's looked at times. I think he's taking the energy out of him a little bit. Evgen been the more composed, picked the shots a little bit better.
Evgen's been much the more relaxed of the two fighters, and I think that's certainly played in his favour.
Another beautiful low kick there. And just picking him off as he's coming in with a... sharp left hook from Evgen there.
Yeah, Alex looking to use his hands in the clinch rather than his knees.
Referee there just warning him against trying to trip in the clinch.
Was that because he was tripping with the back of his leg rather than the front? It's not allowed in Muay Thai, more of a judo technique. Out of
Alex
him.
In there with a hook. Evgen looking a little bit tired now. Very fast pace for two big guys.
Alex taking a deep breath. He's still quite light on his feet, but he's not bouncing around nearly as much as he was in the opening round.
Evgen definitely slowed up a bit now. He's not getting the shots. Nice knee there though to end the round. End of round number four. The Russian fighter. Alex reliant a little bit on the one-shot punching.
Yeah, all fight really. Alex has just been looking to land a big punch, and to be honest, I think that might be his best strategy going into this final round. You'd have to assume he's behind on the scorecards.
Final round coming up. Evgen Golovin from Russia in the blue shorts. Alex Poptirantam from America in the red shorts. 94 kilos. One more round left.
Be interesting to know what Evgen's corner said to him at the start of this round, whether they told him that he could afford to take his foot off the gas, or whether he still needs to win this round to win the fight.
Good counter work from Evgen.
Yeah, Alex throwing, putting so much behind those punches. He's almost spinning himself around 360 degrees, throwing himself off balance and leaving himself open to counters.
Nice left hook there from Alex. From Evgen, sorry.
Yeah, Alex took it well.
He's just beaten into the shot every time so far in this round.
Evgen with his hands very low.
Switching in the southpaw there, Alex. Trying to keep away from that damaged leg, possibly.
Both men really holding their hands close to their weight, close to their waist, excuse me.
And a hard low kick there.
And a nice counter left.
Say in the Muay Thai fight, it's all about the effect and showing the effect of the shot. And every time he's been landing with those low kicks in the later rounds, he's shown a lot of effect with them, Evgen. So.
Alex really swinging for the fences here. Credit to him, he's not ready to concede defeat.
Couple of hard left hooks there from Evgen. Another good low kick from him, off balancing Alex again. Controlled the clinch quite well, Evgen, as well, in the blue shorts.
See if Alex has got enough left in the tank for one last burst here.
He's walked on another hard left hook there.
He's really telegraphing his punches now, just leaping forwards. And I think Yevgeny's groin guard's going to need some quick adjustments. Okay, he's good to go. The fight continues.
And that left hook from Evgen, finding the target. He's walking onto a lot now, Alex. Beautiful uppercut there. He's rocking his head back.
Alex tries to counter with a left hook on his own, but Evgeny just moves out of the way of it.
Again, that hard low kick. He's hurt now, he's just bouncing up on one leg there.
Yeah, well, I don't think he's going to be going dancing in Pattaya tonight. Alex just catches Evgeny's kick and sweeps his standing leg. I think it's probably too little too late for the American at this stage.
Oh yeah, he's lost this round big. Another hard low kick at the bell. And the referee in there to tell him it's all over. And a show of respect for me, Spider, now. We wait for the three referees, judges' scorecards at ringside.
Let's hear it for your two fighters.
There you have it, the winner on points. No real surprises there.
Once in a lifetime.
From Russia, the winner on points.
Corrupt Young Gotti.
Yeah, even though Alex has had three times many fights
in
his
the blue corner,
to be the more experienced.
Evgen Golovin by decision.
An entertaining scrap we had there for the second event.
Introducing the X-Man Phenomenal, X-Files the Chronicle, Aristotle Chronicle, Magnificent Beast, Exhibit stick to the logic, you can be bullish and brawl like your ass will still get demolished, polished and keeping them modest, my niggas eat like piranhas, we party stupid retarded, most niggas hated and garnered, cause they not popular product, this ain't no Gucci or Prada.